in black.
We work in secret. We work in secret. We exist in shadow. We exist in shadow.
And we dress in black.
And we dress in black.
For as long as there have been sightings, there have been reports of these dark, mysterious men in black.
What do these men look like?
Now, usually I'm really good with faces, but this time all I can remember is how they were dressed. They
all were in black?
How'd you know that?
Since the 50s, people who have had close encounters have reported subsequent visitations from these unearthly men in black.
Even the 90s sci-fi hit The X-Files have included these mysterious figures into their storyline.
Venus was at its peak brilliance last night. You probably thought you saw something up in the sky other than Venus. But I assure you, it was Venus.
I know.
The men in black are reported to be very serious, possibly part of a secret government agency, working as part of a conspiracy to hide evidence of UFO activity on Earth. Their role is to make witnesses forget what they've seen. But now Barry Sonnenfeld gives us a comical look into the life of the men in black. They are the best kept secret on the planet.
We'll take it from here.
Who the hell are you?
INS Division 6.
There is no Division 6.
Their mission is to monitor extraterrestrial activities on Earth.
You sold a reverberating carbonizer with mutate capacity to an unlicensed cephalopoid, Jeeves.
It looked all right to me.
Columbia Pictures.
Very quiet, please. Roll sound.
Mark.
And Amblin Entertainment present Tommy Lee Jones.
Sir, you can't just...
Don't sir me, young man. You have no idea who you're dealing with.
And Will Smith in a film by Barry Sonnenfeld.
And action.
Jay, something's peaking.
You're doing fine, Ace.
Men in black.
What happens in this story? Tommy Lee Jones was one of the founding members of the Men in Black.
Put up your arms and all you flippers.
The idea is that we have to keep all this alien traffic through our little backwater border town of a planet secret.
Give me a splay burn around the perimeter with holes at 40, 60, and 80 meters.
All the men in black are kind of old, and it's time to recruit new members, and I'm the first new member that Tommy Lee recruits.
You're all here because you're the best of the best.
What's so funny, Edwards?
I got no clue why we're here.
It's a science fiction action comedy. With a twist.
Very few directors we felt were right for this movie. It was a very short list, and Barry was at the top of it, because there are few people who I think can combine the sense of style it needed, the comic tones. He's delivering the movie we all envisioned.
Yeah, he has his ability to be smart in a stupid way and stupid in a smart way. He's very sophisticated visually. It's quite elegant, and yet he has an pretty perfect pitch about, you know, where the laugh is.
Then I believe you're looking for tips in the supermarket tabloids.
Not looking for. Found.
I did it because it looked like a real good idea. I signed on just from reading the comic books before there was even a script. I said, I'd really like to do this because I think, you know, smart and talented people will come to it.
I, on the other hand, read the script, loved it because it has my sort of quirky philosophy about life, which is that we don't have a clue. One of the things I like about the movie is that there aren't just bad aliens. There are bad aliens or good aliens or boring aliens. There are aliens that are just disgruntled workers at MIB headquarters that spend all their time drinking coffee and smoking cigarettes and stealing secretarial supplies.
Director Barry Sonnenfeld, who also directed The Addams Family and Get Shorty, managed to earn the respect of all his performers, human or otherwise.
So, you know, just to calm him down, and if I sense a little bit of nervousness from you in your body language, that's fine. Okay.
There are around 1,500 aliens on the planet, most of them right here in Manhattan.
Cab drivers.
Not as many as you'd think.
Coming up on MIB Invasion, Special Agent AB will continue our investigation by interviewing Tommy Lee Jones, Will Smith, and one very gruesome alien.
Cool.
Cool. What you don't realize, Zar, is that the aliens are everywhere.
Especially on Network 10. That's right, Jay. Tonight at 8:30, we'll be showing you a special Aliens director's cut, digitally remastered in widescreen format.
That's great, Zar, but with all the aliens around, it's going to be hard to keep track of them. I think it's time we called upon Special Agent AB.
Thank you, Jay. Thank you, Zar. My first assignment tonight, to go behind the scenes and talk to some of our people on the inside.
I am just a figment of your imagination.
These are the men in black. Tommy Lee Jones is the veteran K, Will Smith, the rookie J.
Jay is NYPD, I'm a detective, and kind of look down on the other officers in the force because, you know, I kind of take my job really seriously. I stay in shape, and I just, you know, I think that being a police officer is something that's really important, and we're performing a service that is vital to the community. And, you know, a lot of the other officers are kind of lax and allow themselves to get overweight and not really be. The movie opens up with my pursuit. Whoa, ho, ho. Men in black, get it?
In the movie, chooses Jay because he's a really good cop. He has a good head on his shoulders. And he chases down a particularly nimble and malevolent alien in the course of his work as a New York cop. And this impresses the men in black who are looking for a replacement for a recently retired agent.
But Jay has no idea of the life he's taken on.
You want some coffee?
No, thank you, I'm fine.
Wanga!
Wanga!
How you doing, fellas?
Okay.
That's not decaf, is it?
Viennese cinnamon.
Oh, don't tell me we only got that powdered stuff with cream again. I hate that stuff.
No, the Greek has a twaka.
Oh, it's good. You guys get along all right?
No, it's
well, don't work too hard.
It doesn't look like this was a tough set to work on. In fact, these guys had fun. Tommy Lee Jones, the acclaimed actor, who has starred in 25 films, including Batman Forever, JFK, and his Oscar-winning role in The Fugitive, took to sci-fi adventure comedy like an alien to slime.
I don't know anything about funny. I follow his direction, stand next to him. You're funny right there.
I don't suppose you know what kind of alien life form leaves a green spectral trail in Cray Sugar Water, do you?
Oh, wait, that was on Final Jeopardy last night.
Will Smith is no slouch in the acting stakes either, having appeared in the blockbuster Bad Boys and that other alien record breaker, Independence Day. His natural comedy was first brought to our attention on the TV series The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
This is for you.
Oh, but I didn't get you anything.
And he carries that right through this movie.
You know what the difference is between you and me? I make this look good.
Anytime an alien makes themselves known, the men in black have to go and basically clean up the mess. So now that the guy's dead, the men in black have to come, scoop the body, find out who knows what, erase people's memories, clean it up, put everything back the way that it was.
There are one or two other human co-stars.
Linda Fiorentino plays Laurel Weaver. She's the deputy medical examiner.
She's a coroner. She hangs out with dead people.
We always wind up having to go see her because she's always finding all of these bizarre creatures. Linda gives the movie a really heated, sultry, give me some more adjectives, for Linda, the sexy.
Those are two good ones.
Yes, yes. Heated, sexy, sultry. Heated, sensual.
Quirky,
off-center. Off-center, sassy.
There's something I need to show you.
Slow down, girl. You ain't gotta hit the gas like that.
No, you don't understand. You really need to see this.
Oh, I will. Oh, one thing.
I gotta drive. You know, it's not some macho trip. I'm what I'm saying. That's just the way I get down.
Tony Shalhoub, who's best known for playing Antonio in the hit TV comedy Wings, has a great role.
Hold on a second.
I'm gonna count to three.
He'll do it, Jeeve. Talk to me. He is just crazy when he's like this.
He's always crazy. Why don't you get a massage? Take a cruise.
You insensitive. Do you have any idea how much that stings?
It was one of those fortunate situations where I didn't exactly have to audition. I was asked to do it. I don't know how you audition for a part where you get your head blown off and then it comes back. So I couldn't figure out how to do that in an audition anyway.
In the role of Zed, leader of the Men in Black, Rip Torn.
Kate! Give the kid a weapon.
Well, I think they still serve our civilization as it is, and I think they would consider themselves patriots, but they're pretty wise patriots. They know a lot more than the usual citizen.
My name is Zed. You're all here because you're the best of the best. Marines, Air Force, Navy SEALs, Army Rangers, NYPD. And we're looking for one of you. Just one.
But it's Vincent D'Onofrio, former boyfriend to Australia's Greta Scacchi, who'll be hardest to forget.
Useless, Beatrice.
The only thing that pulls its weight around here is my goddamn truck.
Vincent D'Onofrio's character is a simple redneck idiot.
Vegas.
And he's visited by an alien who eats him. He just simply wraps this idiot's skin in coveralls so that he'll have a disguise while he's going about his villainy here on Earth.
It makes the character very frustrated and angry that he's got to be stuffed into this body. He doesn't enjoy what's happening very much.
Hey, your skin is hanging off your bones.
Oh, yeah. Is that better?
Vincent D'Onofrio is hilarious in the movie. I just saw how great his performance was, and it was hilarious.
Vincent was really cool at playing. I mean, trying to impersonate a bug who's wearing a human skin for a suit. Mm-hmm. What would somebody like that do? What would their mannerisms be like? Mm-hmm. I mean, and, you know, there's not a lot of information available on that. There's not a lot of research you can do.
Hey, this is my truck!
Yeah, and make sure you tell him that down at the impound.
He wants to take over the universe like all bad guys do, you know?
Please.
But it was some makeup job to create this lovable character.
It's an amazing job that they did, you know. It's all done with silicone. It's brand new stuff that's never been done before for a major thing like this anyway. It's all working so well.
Everything looks so real. You know, you can't tell where the makeup starts and where Vincent stops, or where Vincent stops and the makeup starts. One of those is right.
They actually stretch the bottom eyelids down and glue them down and glue bits here down and then put the pieces on top of that. It's very odd. It's very weird and painful. You gotta just zone out.
Vincent's great. He spends 6.5 hours in makeup every day to look almost normal. That's the funny part.
I'm doing a show. I love it.
Yes, good. Thank you. Thank you for making sure the bell works.
Well, don't do that.
By the end of the movie, we get to see the bug inside Vincent come out.
Like this?
Coming up on MIB Invasion, we'll be looking at some of the techniques used in how to make your everyday alien.
We'll also be looking at the latest merchandise, which some people say is as important as those box office figures. Welcome back to MIB Invasion. Now, if everyone who saw an alien remembered it, the MIB would have a very big problem.
What's that?
This R is a neuralizer. The moment I use it, you will forget everything.
What's that?
This R is a neuralizer. The moment I use it, you will forget everything.
The
Men in Black have neuralizers. What neuralizers do is they make you forget things. Oh, yeah, you didn't master me. Oh, whoa. Tommy Lee knows everything. Tommy Lee Jones knows everything. But like neuralizers, you can flash it and it erases your memory.
I knew it. This is an alien, and you guys are from some government agency trying to keep it under wraps.
No.
They keep having to neuralize her so she'll forget everything she's seen.
Hey, whoever you guys are, you're gonna have to show me some ID if you're gonna be in the morgue.
Oh, yes, of course, young lady. Have a look at this for me, please. Would you stop that?
The neuralizer, one of the most popular MIB tools. Used to erase someone's memory, allowing them to implant a new explanation of events.
He asked me for some water. Some, sugar water.
Sugar water?
Yeah, if I remember that right. Because I thought that that was odd. They'd ask me for sugar water or not. Lemonade or ice water or regular water or tap water.
All right, Beatrice. There was no alien. Flash of light you saw in the sky was not a UFO. Swamp gas from a weather balloon was trapped in a thermal pocket and refracted the light from Venus.
Well, wait a minute. So you just flash that thing, it erases our memory, and you just make up a new one?
A standard issue neuralizer.
And that weak story is the best you can come up with.
All right. On a more personal note, Beatrice, Edgar ran off with an old girlfriend. You're gonna go stay with your mom a couple of nights, you're gonna get over it and decide you're better off.
Well, yeah, you know, because he never appreciated you anyway. In fact, you know what? You kicked him out. And now that he's gone, you're gonna go in town, you go to Bloomingdale's, you find yourself some nice dresses, get yourself some shoes, you know, find somewhere, maybe you get a facial, and, hire a decorator to come in here quick, because... damn.
As any MIB will tell you, an arsenal of weapons is required to complete the job.
Series 4 deatomizer.
Well, that's what I'm talking about.
Noisy cricket.
I feel like I'm gonna break this damn thing.
Part of the treaty with the aliens is that they give us technology.
Ooh, watch your head! Oh. Somebody get him some ice! Ooh.
Oh! Things that humankind has always pondered, the MIBs get to actually experience.
You remember the little red button?
Yeah.
Push the little red button. And you may want to put on a seatbelt.
K.
To bring Men in Black's unique alien life to the screen, producers Walter Parks and Laurie McDonald turned to four-time Academy Award winner Rick Baker.
Rick Baker has created just really, really special creatures.
Rick's stuff is not only really imaginative, but it's really witty. I mean, there's spin on all of it, and both of the things are absolutely essential.
This one film, we're building like, you know, 12-foot bug monster and a little, you know, 2-inch man. That's what's fun about this. You know, we're doing, you know, we've got men in suits, we've got little mechanical guys, we've got big mechanical guys, you know, all kinds of makeups. Pretty much everything that I've done through my career all packed into one movie.
I wonder what kind of childhood he had, you know? I mean, Rick is a nice guy, but there must be some weird stuff going on in his crib at night.
In general, there are different ways to create aliens. Some of the creatures are puppets.
Prime examples of Baker's puppet work were the aliens, which were affectionately called the Worm Guys.
Barry liked them a lot, so we had to do another scene, so they did this scene in the little kind of employee lunchroom. They were actually the first aliens that we made. As we did thousands of designs, Tony Urbano and all the puppeteers just really took off with it and had a lot of fun.
You sorry little ingrates!
The second way to create an alien is through robotics, as found in the character of the Bolshan High Prince.
The guy's head opens up, and there's like a little green guy driving the body inside of there.
To do this, I mean, the problem is it's really hard to articulate a man, you know, a little green man that's this big. You know, his mouth is like that big. Sometimes we have to build really complex, you know, electronic mechanisms and you know, hydraulic and all kinds of stuff. It depends on what we're doing. And what it has to do to how we motivate it.
That was actually one of the first aliens that I saw when I came on the film, and that really charged me up.
Your money, Jay Heister, Kopstrom.
Mikey, when they let you out of jail?
Perhaps the ultimate challenge for Baker was the 8-foot-tall alien, Mikey, who, because of the complex actions required, utilised a mixture of all the elaborate techniques. Even with the incredible creature work done by Rick Baker and his team, there were certain circumstances where additional effects work was needed. When these situations came up, the filmmakers turned to the folks at Industrial Light and Magic.
The mechanical devices that are used on set are always limited to what can a lot of puppeteers be choreographed to do in unison.
When I needed him to be angry and roar, that head couldn't do that, so that particular shot will be totally done on a computer.
So first we start with the models. The next thing that happens is that someone goes in and paints the colors and textures onto it so that it looks like the real creature. Then the next thing we do is we add animation to it. And then we do a digital composite, which takes that three-dimensional object and puts it against the real live-action background plate. And when everything's all sanded down to a fine edge, then the shot's done.
Industrial Light and Magic also created numerous other computer-generated effects for use throughout the film.
We can do creatures, we can do flying saucers, we can do sort of state-of-the-art computer-generated monsters, and then something that looks like a 50s science fiction movie scene.
Merchandising plays a big part in a movie's success, and Men in Black is no exception. It's where the audience can take home their own piece of the movie. From T-shirts, books, trading cards and watches, to sunglasses, and yes, even your very own alien to take home, while you listen to the MIB soundtrack and read your comic.
Coming up on MIB Invasion, Special Agent AB will be going to one of the hottest premieres in town.
What's up, Sydney?
When Men in Black opened in Sydney, everyone wanted to be at the premiere party.
Entry was, of course, restricted, unless you had these
exclusive tickets.
I'll take those, boys. This was the only way into the Australian premiere, where A-list celebrities rubbed shoulders with the man in black himself, Will Smith. These exclusive shots of the antics at the after-show party should show you what it's like on the other side.
Coming to you live and directly in Australia's premiere, The Men in Black.
Men and women in black poured out of limos and jived up the red carpet, sunglasses on, ready to expect the unexpected.
Who's my favourite alien? Me. I come from another world.
As well as a pack of celebrities, there was a huge crowd outside. Mad Will Smith fans who wanted to see their favourite alien fighter up close and in the flesh. And they didn't have to wait long.
Ladies and gentlemen, The Men in Black!
Nothing was up, they were just pleased to see him. And unlike many visiting stars, Will spent some serious time with his fans.
We are a secret government organization. We police and monitor alien traffic on and off of the planet Earth. Whoa, y'all stopping bus traffic. Y'all stopping the buses. So hey, look, we're coming down here. We're ready.
Even a little song was no trouble.
You got to meet Will! Will you ever wash your hand again?
Fortunately, the other MIBs, the men in blue, were there to help calm the crowd down. Meantime, the celebs watched the flick before boarding buses to another world, specially created at Sydney's overseas passenger terminal.
It's a night on the horizon, bright light into sight, tight camera zoom, one in your pens and doom. But then like boom, black suits fill the room up with the quickness, talk with the witnesses.
And didn't the crowd just love it?
I thought it was the funniest thing. It's a really great film.
What did you think of his character?
I thought he was cool. I mean, he did the little talk before the movie and he was so funny. He's such a great comedian and he came across really great in film. He was just a really fun character that you love.
Do we have any aliens like that in Australia?
Oh, I've met quite a few. At every club or every sort of party I ever go to, I meet aliens, I think. Maybe they think I'm an alien.
It just makes everything clear now. It really, really does.
You asked me before who my favourite alien was, and I think I'd have to say Glenn A. Baker. Oh, and also my fiancée, Annalise.
After tonight, that movie's convinced me. I reckon I've got about 115 working for me. I'm not going to name names, but I think I know who they are now.
Men in Black means to me a hell party at the end of the movie, but, I'd say it means, you know, a bit of fun, a bit of adventure, a bit of escapism, basically just a good movie.
And what a party it was. On stage, more men and women in black, this time provided by designers Morrissey Edmiston. And then some honours for the star.
From that point on, Will went on to win Grammy Awards, and really also had a fantastic career, television and movies.
First, Will sussed out his crowd.
Were you all at the movie, or like some of you didn't go to the movie and just came to the party because you like free drinks?
Then he got down to the serious business of accepting gold awards for both the single and album Men in Black.
This is a nice plaque, and of all the awards that I've received, this is the most recent.
But he did seem genuinely happy to be here.
When I was just a boy, I asked Terry, what should I say? But she wouldn't tell me. But you don't know Terry. So I'm very excited and very happy to be here. Don't people always say that when they're in a different country? I am so happy to be here. No, but really, because like Australia is like far from everywhere. And it was really important to me to come here.
Everyone at the bash was genuinely excited to be rubbing black-clad shoulders with this star, but few were as lucky as Ruben.
Ruben.
Yes.
Yes. You're from Australia?
Certainly.
So, like, it's fun being a man in black, right?
It's not bad. It's pretty cool.
Chicks dig it, right?
Yeah, they do.
Because you're on stage. Do you know right now, I'm getting you a date right now.
A few weeks earlier, on the other side of the planet, it was Men in Black's world premiere. Once again, that shy flower, Will Smith, was the centre of attention, along with his beautiful co-star, Linda Fiorentino.
The thing is, you can't look at aliens and try to determine with your eyes. You can tell by their accomplishments, the things that they do. Aliens usually perform great feats. Tiger Woods, for example, is absolutely an alien. Absolutely, no question. Michael Jordan is absolutely an alien. Steven Spielberg, absolutely an alien. You know, aliens stand out.
I've worked with other aliens in the past, and so I think we all have in Hollywood.
Anyone who sees this movie can become an alien spotter. In fact, my goal is when you leave the theater and you go past the people waiting online for another show, you too will be able to say, third one in the green jacket, alien.
It's all about the attitude. When you approach an alien, you have to approach with an attitude. That's the attitude.
And that attitude must be hereditary. Will Smith's son has it too.
That's Trey. Trey, can you tell when you see an alien?
You know an alien?
You know an alien?
MIB, Dad.
MIB. That's right.
MIB.
That's Men in Black.
After the screening, the excitement continued with an out-of-this-world party.
I thoroughly enjoyed it. I thought Will Smith and Tommy Lee Jones just worked so amazingly together.
It's very fun. It's very original, very fun, and it's a damn good show. Happy days balancing with life's atrocities.
Hopping in V's, knowing something I got to leave properly. So that's what it's like on the other side.
Coming up on MIB Invasion, we take a look at the multi-talented Will Smith, who not only content with just acting with aliens, has chosen to dance with them. Introducing myself, Agent J, Agent R, and Special Agent AB. You're watching the MIB Invasion, or should we be calling it the Will Smith Invasion? Over to you, Agent R.
Thank you, Agent J. You know, Will Smith has done it all. Music, movies, and dancing. Over to you, Special Agent AB.
Thank you, Agent R. Thank you, Agent J. Will Smith invaded Australia, all right, attending every party in town, including Melbourne's opening of Planet Hollywood and the official All-Star Cafe. He danced, he rapped, he partied. The man was coolness itself. After a few years dedicating himself to movies, Will Smith has grabbed the chance to leap back into music as well.
It's my foray back into the rap world. I'm excited. My album's coming in October, and you know, this entire set is working really hard to make this movie successful, and I am just so happy to be here.
It's much more comfortable to be both racing up the charts on both the cinema and pop. I mean that's got to be the best of all worlds.
Now, from the deepest of the darkest, a night on the horizon, bright light into sight tight.
To me, the soundtrack is really special. In America already, the soundtrack has been number one. And I think what it really highlights is what a multi-talented person Will is. And he's just so committed and dedicated to his career in music and movies.
Will Smith began rapping at 12 and was a millionaire by 18. He burst onto the music scene in 1986 as the Fresh Prince half of Grammy-winning rap duo DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. And here's the roll call of hits.
My parents are the same no matter time or place. They don't understand that us kids are going to make some mistakes. So to you other kids all across the land, there's no need to argue. Parents just don't understand. There was a press conference to see what training I was doing. Before then, I had never heard reporters booing. Cameras flashing, I was in the middle. I didn't want to look dumb, so I exaggerated a little muscle. You could always hop in your car and you can come and ring my bell.
To hear the crowd go boom, shake, shake, shake the room. Boom, shake, shake, shake the room. Boom, shake, shake, shake the room. Tick, 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 boom.
Men in Black gave him the chance to revisit the rap arena.
I signed a new record deal with Columbia Records.
And they said, hey, listen, do you want to make a video? And I said, sure.
Will wrote this song.
And then I saw the Mikey. That was when Mikey inspired me. Mikey was the alien in it.
Mikey is a combination of frog, fish, and turtle. It's a fun kind of thing to work on. And you really have to strip it down to starting with the hips and where people dance from. And, you know, you get his hips and his butt moving, and then everything sort of follows from that.
I wasn't personally attracted to him, just for the record. Yeah, he wasn't strong enough, you know. He just emotionally, he was overbearing, you know.
It just seemed like such a ripe concept, and the Men in Black, the concept of the Men in Black was cool and it looked good.
You know, Michael Jackson's gonna be nervous when he sees this video.
Tell me, what's your knack for picking the biggest hit movie of each year?
Well, see, I got this thing with the aliens, you know. We hooked it up. When they're making a movie, they call me, they let me know, you know, and I jump in and I do my thing. And, you know, generally they take care of me.
It does huge box office. And
you know,
you're
the 4th of July thing in the States, you know, that's that special Big Willie weekend.
Big Willie weekend. Did you believe it would be this big? And I'm not talking about the Willie weekend.
You know, I had no idea. You know, when you're making a film, you always hope that it's successful, you know, but you can't plan this type of success. It's something that just happens and it's really beyond your control.
The fact he can be such a success, yet keep his feet so much on the ground, endears him to cast and crew wherever he goes.
How you came in today with your bottom button open, with your navel showing. That was sexy.
I love Dr. Dre's stuff now, and Tupac, and Snoopy Dogg, I love him.
You had so much success so young. Did you have a clear picture of where you wanted to go?
Not really. Just generally, I try to just maximize every single second of my life and hope that one day you look back and there's a beautiful collage of wonderful moments that make the thing called your life.
You're a poet, too.
Like that? That was kind of poetic. It was profound. Did you see how I looked up? Because, you look up and that, that seems really
over.
Profound.
You won me over. Have you hit any stumbling blocks?
Any stumbling blocks as far as...
In your career. Was there ever a time where it was tough?
Yeah, there's always times when things aren't going the way that you planned, but that's what makes you stronger.
Absolutely.
When things get hard, the hard get going. Yeah. That's not the way that goes.
Something like that.
And now on MIB Invasion, we're proud to bring you this behind-the-scenes look at Will Smith's latest effort, Just Cruising.
Playback.
Coming up on Men in Black, we find out if the movie was as fun to make as it was to watch.
And we ask the question, is there an alien next to you?
Next, the electrifying blockbuster is back. Lance Henriksen, Bill Paxton, Paul Reiser, and Sigourney Weaver.
Get away from her, you bitch!
Aliens, the special edition.
Two juicy pineapple fritters, the West's favourite chips, and a big half barbecue chicken for just $4.95. The Big Treat Half Chicken Tropical Pack, just $4.95 at Chicken Treat now.
What's hot on video?
Mr. President, they have a planet surrounded with thousands of warships.
What do you think, Marcia?
I'm not gonna have that thing in my house.
They blew up Congress!
Attacks.
Why can't we all just get along?
Grab it on video.
Take to Curly with a pair of scissors. Cut out Curly from a Cotties dessert pack, and you could win heaps of prizes every day in the Cotties Goosebumps promotion. Plus one of 10 Ace of PC prize packs. It's simply terrific.
Once you pop, you can't stop.
New salt and vinegar Pringles.
For a frozen pizza to be this perfect, it must be a miracle. McCain Pizza Perfection. Ah, McCain.
Jay, don't you think working on Men in Black would be, like, really cool, what with all of those really good actors and the special effects and the really good storyline, huh? Don't you think that'd be incredible?
Not only have you lost your accent, but you're just so naive. At the end of the day, it's a job. Just a job.
You made Tommy Lee Jones hilarious. You made Will Smith really attractive. You did a great job. You led me. You got Barry, you made it great. You made it so... Barry, you actually suck.
Tommy and I have a very wonderful relationship where basically Tommy says, I work for you, you tell me what to do, where to stand, and I'll do it. You're the boss, and that's the way it is, and I'm here for you.
He's a wonderful director. It's a lot of fun to be on Barry's set. It is therefore okay to ridicule and humiliate him at will.
And you guys just stand there, okay? Good. Ready, Tommy? Any questions, buddy? Okay.
Barry Sonnenfeld, something's wrong with him.
It's like that serious kind of John Wayne thing you got going, you know?
I like him a lot, but he just, sometimes he'll just fall.
After all that crap, we pressed it all morning.
It is brutal.
You know, and his jokes that he tells, they're funny to him.
The thing that all women look for is sense of humor. It's number
sense
one.
Sense of humor, really?
Oh, yeah.
Wow. So you're in.
We met to talk about this movie. He said, now, you know, you have to understand there's no nudity in it.
Yeah, I know.
No what I do, what I say.
Listen, I know Oozes. That. That's why somehow you'll be naked in this movie.
And he thought I wouldn't want to do it because of that.
You know, I really get along with all these actors really well.
I felt I was an actor. You know, I shouldn't have to get smacked.
Okay, we got it. You know, it's best, and Tommy knows this, and it's something you could learn, Will.
Uh-huh.
To be funny,
right.
Try not to be funny.
Try not to.
Yeah.
That's why Tommy is so hilarious, you know, because he doesn't try. He just, you know, He just gives it to you straight ahead.
Some night, huh?
Yeah, some night.
They were gills, not eyelids. Gills, he was out of breath.
Who are you?
Did he say anything to you?
Yeah, he said the world was coming to an end.
Did he say when?
Edward, what the hell happened?
Hesitated.
May I ask why you felt little Tiffany deserved to die?
Well, first I was going to pop this guy hanging from the streetlight, and then I realized, you know, he's just working out. And how would I feel if somebody come running in the gym, bust me in my ass while I'm on a treadmill? Then I saw this snarling beast guy, and I noticed he had a tissue in his hand. I realized, you know, he's not snarling, he's sneezing. And I saw little Tiffany. I'm thinking, you know, 8-year-old white girl, middle of the ghetto, bunch of monsters, this time of night with quantum physics books. She's about 8 years old. Those books are way too advanced for her.
Narrative tricks that invite the audience to gleefully suspend their disbelief, not just willingly. You know?
That's what I meant to say.
The gleeful suspension of disbelief.
The gleeful suspension of disbelief. That's what I was getting at.
And
that's
what I was going Will for. Will is the
glee.
The glee.
Fasten your seatbelt.
See, now we got to work on your people skills. You know, you get a much better reaction if you were a little more polite.
Fasten your seatbelt, please.
Whoa, that was good. Did you hear this? We had a ball making this movie, so I think that when you have that type of fun, the camera can feel that. The camera can pick up on it. I think people are going to enjoy the performances. You know, I think our chemistry and interaction worked out really well.
And that's one of the things this movie makes you do. Sit around and talk about your favorite alien, your favorite scene. I saw the movie 2 nights ago. It was in Chicago, a small screening room, only 48 people. And the next morning they were saying, what's your favorite alien?
We have a really great story. And we have really great actors. And that's really why people go to the movies.
That's what I'm talking about. It's a very action-packed movie.
You're under arrest for violating sections 4153 of the Tyco Treaty.
This is like the ultimate police force. Step away from your busted-ass vehicle and put your hands on your head.
Action!
The universe is a large and varied place. And we are not living at the center of it.
Special Agent AB on a job well done. What a change it was working with a true professional. If you like Aliens, you can see the movie Aliens, Director's Cut, digitally remastered, widescreen format right after this. So, R, what do you think? Any aliens out there?
Well, Agent J, I'm always one step ahead of you. Aliens aren't out there. They're actually right in here.
It's been very amusing. It's been a wonderful experience, and ciao.
I'm sorry, maybe you already answered this, but why exactly are we here?
Sean?
Second Lieutenant Jake Jensen,
West Point, graduate with honors. We're here because you're looking for the best of the best of the best. Sir!
What's so funny, Edwards?
Your boy Captain America over here. Best of the best of the best, sir. With honors. You know, he's just really excited, and he has no clue why we're here. That's very funny to me. Y'all ain't laughing.